The following presentation was recorded at the Buddhist Society of Victoria, Malvern East, Australia. Please visit our website at bsv.net.au.
There's one way which I did teach the kids, and I mentioned it a few days ago here, and it's a nice introduction to actually doing a meditation here. And it was Buddhanusati. Remembering the Buddha, and this is how it's done. A little, very skillful introduction to how to meditate for the big children sitting here in front of me. So if you'd like to get yourselves comfortable, it's going to lead into about a half an hour meditation. I know I've only got 2 hours this afternoon, so I don't want to do too much talking. I started this off with kids, and then some adults were there and said, that really worked for me. So can I teach that to big kids? So here we go. So you're sitting down, close your eyes. And make yourself comfortable. With your awareness, make sure your legs are in the correct position. So ask your legs, how are you? Do you need adjusting? And take this seriously. Don't assume your legs are in the right place. If you're sitting on a chair, sometimes you need to tuck your feet in underneath the chair, sometimes push them out, sometimes separate them. Find the most comfortable position for your legs. Because chairs are usually all the same height, sometimes tall people need to put a cushion underneath their bottom when they're sitting on the chair. Shorter people put a cushion underneath their feet when they're sitting on a chair, thereby adjusting the height so it's comfortable. And once the legs are comfortable, then we check the bottom, make sure that's comfortable. Fidget now and be peaceful afterwards. And pay attention to your back, be mindful of it, and see if you can make the back a little bit more comfortable. And then relax the shoulders. Like imagining the bundles of strings stretched apart. You let them go, so they become loose, with no strain on them. Check your position of your hands. This is mindfulness together with kindness. Aware and caring for these parts of the body so you can put them in such a position that they can be comfortable for the next half hour. And then move attention up to your neck and throat. Trying to bring comfort. And then from the neck up to your head and your face. Feeling any tightness and tension in the muscles. And learning through awareness plus trial and error how to relax those muscles. Once the whole body has been looked at part by part, then we imagine our body as a whole, as a unit, sitting here, relaxed as much as we can. Until we feel the delight of relaxation. Maybe the same feeling when you're on a holiday, you're on your recliner by the beach, or you've just had a hot bath. Muscles all at ease. And then I begin the kids' meditation. I imagine, use my powers of visualization, which are very strong in children. I imagine that I'm the Buddha sitting under the Bodhi tree in Bodh Gaya. 25 centuries ago. Just freshly enlightened. Where I have nothing to do. Nothing more to achieve. All goals have been fulfilled. The long journey has been completed. I'm sitting here, peace at last. Everything is perfect. Nothing needs improving. No ill will left. Everything has its place. Even the crooked trees have their place in the forest. Imagine sitting under the Bodhi tree with a cool wind is blowing over one's face. With silence in the quiet park-like garden next to the river. Sometimes, like, you can imagine the cars to be like the river rushing over the rocks. And it's peaceful. And it's still. And you don't have to achieve anything. All goals have already been achieved. You're just sitting at peace, like a person really has retired from the world. Nothing more to do. Nothing more to gain. At peace. Still. Content. Like the mind of a freshly enlightened Buddha. Imagine what it must have been like. See if you can feel it, imagine it. Actors can sometimes imagine their part so well. It's like they become that part. You see if you can imagine the peace, the contentment, satisfaction of someone who's enlightened. Peace at last. So content, you don't want anything in the whole world. Emotionally, how does that feel? Don't analyze it with intellect. Feel it with your emotions. The emotion of deep equanimity, peace, and happiness. Nothing missing, nothing excess, and the mind balanced. I will now be quiet until the end of the half hour. How do you feel right now? How did that imagination, visualization of being enlightened at the beginning set the scene and give you an emotional idea of what meditation is? Feeling peace, being satisfied, not wanting anything in the whole world. Unknowing the gong.